Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear wonderful people, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set rules on earth. Whoever follows them gets a result. Whoever doesn't follow them will not get a result. The only time you get a result without following rules is when it's a miracle. And that miracle was given once and hardly ever happens these days except here and there, but it's not the norm. For instance, when you get hungry, you gotta eat. You don't eat, you're not gonna satisfy the hunger. It don't matter how much Quran you read, it don't matter how much dhikr you make, you will get. Why? Because the law that Allah put on earth means this: hungry, eat. You want a babies, you get married. It's cold outside, you wear clothes, you get the idea. These laws, whoever takes them gets, whoever doesn't take them doesn't get. And this is like, please pay attention to this. Insha'Allah does not affect the result. Insha'Allah, as I already explained in my talk, is the beginning. It's like saying Bismillah. Insha'Allah is the beginning of the action. But when do we actually start? In my talk today in a group where a young lady, Jazallah Khair, asked the question as to how I managed to put in my time, what it is, and I gave about 4 to 5 points about what it is that I do that makes a difference in my day. And then I felt a resistance from some people that are allergic to the term planning. Some of them think that planning, you become like a robot. Well, actually it's not. Planning is a human deed that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. This is why, my brothers and my sisters, at the time of the immigration or the migration from Mecca to Al-Madina, Ummuna Aisha, as in Al-Bukhari, says that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to us at a time he was not used to come. Rasulullah used to go to the house of Abu Bakr every night to work out on the da'wah. It was not an archaic, chaotic move. No, Rasulullah would sit with Abu Bakr every night and they will agree. Who did we speak to today? We should speak to the other one. Oh, did you know the other one embraced Islam? And they used to talk like this. Rasulullah would plan his day, how it goes. And then before that, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, before created the heavens and the earth, what did he write? Allah doesn't need to write. Why he wrote everything in the preserved tablet, Allah al-Mahfuz, 50,000 years before the creation. 50,000 years and he didn't touch nothing. And then as Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked in his preserved tablet and created. That's what I call the wonderful planning. Muslims today, we have this allergy to planning. We think like planning is not us. I live my day as it comes. Well, my brothers and my sisters, if you do that, you're gonna waste your life. Not planning is not a characteristic of successful people. Successful people plan. It always has been, it is today, and will always be. How does Al-Quran talk to us? And how does the Sunnah, hand in hand? Rasulullah ﷺ, when he talks about Salat al-Istikhara, a lot of people don't get 100% out of their Istikhara, not even 40%. It's because they do it wrong. It's like you go to an exam and they tell you to write with pencils, you take a pen and you write with it and then you fail the exam. It's not because the knowledge was not good, it's because you have not followed the instruction properly. Now, al-Istikhara, Rasulullah ﷺ says, إِذَا هَمَّ أَحَدُكُمْ بِالْأَمْرِ. Al-ham in Arabic, again this is a translation, but al-ham in Arabic is this: when you have made the study, fully studied the plan, made an action plan and made everything, now all you have to do is say Bismillah and you start in the action. If you are sitting, al-ham means you putting your hands on the floor and getting up. That's the ham. What Rasulullah tells us, when you have studied and planned and got ready, now it's time to put to practice. At that time there, you pray the 2 rakat al-istikhara and you move on. This action of al-istikhara is what Allah says in Al-Quran in Surah Muhammad, فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Once you have again made your plans and fully totally agreed and dedicated yourself that you are going to start doing something, tawakkal ala Allah. What does the word tawakkal ala Allah? At-tawakkul is like al-ittikal. Al-ittikal is to rely on somebody. Meaning, you go out to do your action with everything that you have planned, and on the other hand, you know nothing you can do by yourself, so you rely on Allah to give you the sufficient energy that you have in your mind to produce what you want to produce. This is at-tawakkul. This is why Ibn Taymiyyah alayhi rahmatullah says, at-tawakkul and at-tawakkul. These are two very close words. Tawakkul means what I said. You studied, you planned, you took every precaution to make your project successful. And then you ask Allah for help and you go and do it. At-tawakkul is when you don't plan, you do absolutely nothing, and then you say, Ya Allah, help me. Ibn Taymiyyah says, in that circumstance, when you ask Allah without taking the steps of success, you're making fun of Allah, and that is haram. It's like someone who doesn't get married and every night and day, Ya Allah, give me a child. That person there is actually pulling somebody's leg, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to punish him for that. My brothers and my sisters, pay attention. I feel a resistance from Muslims, young Muslims in the group. They resist change for the love of Allah. The old cultural bad habits, they're not even in Islam. Al-Islam says, فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ. When you have decided, تَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. When do you take a decision? Do you take a decision based on ignorance, or do you take a decision based on knowledge? That's why they call them decision makers. The decision makers will require some data analysis. There is people behind that that study the data and put it in a way where the decision makers look at it, take a decision and do it. Why I plan my day? Pretty simple. You plan either you like it or not. Here is why. Do you plan for your money? Do you actually know every month I get 1,000 pounds, 400 pounds go to rent, 200 pounds goes this, 100 pounds goes here, That's planning. Why don't you do the same thing with your time? Those people who live without a plan, and actually they are not living, they are getting by. It's like someone who is living a lifestyle and someone who is surviving. Not planning is a survival. Planning is a lifestyle. I repeat it and write it down, please, in gold. Not planning, leading a life with no planning is survival. Leading a life with planning is a lifestyle. Don't tell me everything is in my head and I do it. You cannot be smarter than Rasulullah ﷺ. And you couldn't outsmart Allah. Could you now? If Allah, who knows everything, does not forget a thing, the first thing He created is the pen, that is after the ocean and the al-arsh, the throne. The first thing for this world is the pen. The second thing, the preserved tablet. You telling me you're human, you don't need to plan, is because you don't have much going on in your day. That's why you don't need to plan. And as I said, my brothers and my sisters, days are named different. Al-Ahad, Al-Ithnain, Al-Thulatha, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and this. Why? Because they have different entities. There is the beginning of the week, there is the middle of the week, and there is the end of the week. In the business world, the most dead day for business is Tuesday. And that's why most of the offers go on Tuesdays. My brothers and my sisters, until when are you going to lead a life with no plannings? Until when you die. Subhanallah, don't you remember that when you die on the day of Qiyamah, you will come with a book of action? How did that book come for? Because your actions were counted. Everything. You are part of a big plan, my brothers and my sisters. Don't let shaitan fool you. Don't let your culture fool you. And certainly don't let these intellectual barriers that you put on yourself. The members of the group says, don't you feel like a robot? Actually, I'd rather feel like a robot than a leaf in the wind. My brothers and my sisters, let's not take these things out of context. When you plan, you lead a lifestyle. That's the end of it. I wake up in the morning, I get up in the morning, I know what my day is like. I've already told you this in my pep talk. I have my four rak'at that I do them. The first two rak'at is my allegiance to Allah straight away. The two other rak'at, I do them because for a blessed day of my day and for Salat al-Duha. Before Dhuhr, I pray four, and after Dhuhr, I pray four. Why all these things? they are part of a big plan. You're telling me I don't need to plan? No wonder we Arabs and we Muslims are at the bottom in the list of people who are producers in this world. My brothers and my sisters, why do I feel this resistance? Why we Muslims don't believe? One day I was in a seminar, or the conference hall took around 10,000 people. We were 10,000 people under that roof. This guy comes out and the room is cheering up. I forgot the name now, but we were like, wow, mashallah, this guy is coming out. You know what this guy did? He took a pencil. Pencil, wallahi al-azim, not bigger than your index. And the camera zoomed in into it. And he said, in these very words, he goes, do you know what this is? Everybody kept quiet because it's a pencil. And then he said this, this is the most powerful tool against any human mind. Because if you write, I need to do this tomorrow at 10 a.m. and you put it on a wall, or you trust it to your mind, how many times have you forgotten? How many times have you said, I will do things and you didn't do it until people started calling you, oh, you only speak. It's no action talk only person, because you didn't write. Me, before I open my mouth, I document. I know tomorrow who is coming to me, and I know next Monday between 4 and 5 who is coming to see me, and I know this Juma at 3 o'clock where I should be, and I know this weekend where I should be. My life is at peace. And let me tell you something, my dear brothers and my sisters. When you don't plan, you are draining your mind. You are taxing your mind by keeping something in it all the time. That's why we say it's something on my mind. Don't you feel better when you confine in someone? Which one is better to you? When you confine into someone a problem, or when you keep it inside you, eats you? Plan is the same thing. As soon as you write, you have confined something inside you on a piece of paper in the world, in our world of people who teach people how to lead a better lifestyle. We call it, you are ahead from the regular Joe public or Abdullah public by 94%. Don't be fooled with this un-Islamic dead culture. You become a robot, or your life doesn't have a good sense in it. These are the people, the chaotic people who think like that. The people who think like this, they sleep in sleeping bag under bridges. And that's why people who plan are executives, directors of banks, and they are directors of companies, because they plan. Don't be a loser, because on the day of Qiyamah, you'll be asked about your time and what did you do with it and where did you spend it. And Allah has sent you all measures on how to plan your time. How come today our Prophet planned his time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote everything that he is to create until eternity. Eternity is written. On the day of Qiyamah, you will bring your book. In Al-Jannah, your names are written. Who is going to enter Al-Jannah? Have you forgotten? Your angels write your actions. Why do they write them? If it was just about keeping in the mind, they could just watch you. The angels do not forget. Allah can make them exactly like computers. They would never forget a single thing. He will make their eyes like video cameras, and that's it. But why do they write? Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, for the love of Allah. Let's wake up from this long, long, long slumber that is leading us to destruction, leading us to leading a survival mode. It's sad. Many people go for years living in a survival world, and others living in a lifestyle. It pains me to death to see non-Muslims living in a lifestyle, and Muslims with all that we have, all what Islam gives us, surviving day after day. Kids are killing me. Circumstances of this, circumstances of that. I can't do this. I've done that. That person there, this person that. Chaos, chaos. No, my brothers and my sisters, don't be fooled. Plan your day, you design a lifestyle. You don't plan your day, you are surviving. You plan your day, you are maximizing on the usage of the time. You don't plan your day, it's like a ball of tennis. You are thrown here and there. You are just like a leaf that the wind plays with. Here, there. You are pushed here and there. Every day, at the end of the day, when you look back on your day, and you find that you have done nothing in that day, that's because you have not planned. When I get up in the morning, I have 10 things to do. Guess what? At night when I go to bed and I go, yes, I've done these 10 things. Can you account to the same? Can you feel happy when you go to bed? If feeling happy and leading a lifestyle and being in good terms with Allah and increasing myself and using the better my time means I am a robot, I love being this robot. But if doing the otherwise makes you seem a loser, then I would like you to think twice, my brothers and my sisters. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that my words are clear. If you have problems planning your day, get in touch with me, I can help you. Or attend my classes on Wednesdays. I also hold Thursday classes here in my home. It's called The Journey, where I teach people how to plan their time, their lives, how to become a better person. Believe me, you need a lifestyle, enough of survival mode. I will send a picture with this talk here of my little pad, where it's called my to-do pad. I use pads here and it's always by my side, and when something happens, I write it down. Whenever I feel something or my brain brings in something to do, I write it down. Right now I can tell you about 20 things, like now I'm looking at this, I bought this, I bought that, and I did this. So that's it, 3 things on 2, 4, 6, 8 of 7 things. Alhamdulillah. So my brothers and my sisters, for the love of Allah, take your life seriously. Anarchy is not serious. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you and myself to the best of guidance. فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. When you have decided, studied, taken a decision, then rely upon Allah. And I pray to Allah that you are going to start taking your religion seriously. Again, this is your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa, 07876-408735. If you know of any web designers, please do let them get in touch with me. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.